If the measurement plane is different from the calibration plane, de-embedding, embedding, and port extensions can help compensate for the loss caused by the additional fixture. These functions are usually a built-in feature in most VNA software. De-embedding and embedding have actually proven to be the most accurate way to remove or add any additional circuitry, as the fixture is mathematically excluded or included with the help of a touchstone file. So in these touchstone files, there are S parameter values at various frequency points. And by referring to the data in this file, the software can accurately calculate the fixture effects and then remove them from the measurements. There is another simpler way to de-embed a fixture, and that is with the help of the port extension function. This function virtually extends the test ports by moving the calibration plane to the terminals of the DUT. However, this is done by just adding an electrical delay, and it assumes that the transmission line is kind of lossless. So if you see any ripples caused due to mismatches, then de-embedding using a touchstone file would be a better option. But these days, there is also an auto port extension function available, which allows for automatic calculation of port extension parameters by measuring short or an open standard. The result of the auto port extension function is actually the calculation of the electrical delay value. Once the de-embedding function is performed, the measurement plane moves towards the plane of the DUT.